So hello friends, welcome to my channel Jobonymous, and in today's video I am going to discuss with you Amazon's transportation specialist job position which has been floated by them on their website. So for this opening, freshers as well as experienced person can apply, and in this video we are going to discuss about the eligibility criteria, how you can apply for it, its job description and the interview rounds and the questions and answers that are commonly asked for this position. So please watch this video till the end so that you can feel confident to apply for this position. And please do like this video because it gives me a lot of motivation to make such videos for you that requires a lot of hard work. And in case you have landed new to my channel, consider subscribing it because I make videos on job opportunities and interview preparation. So let's start today's video with the first thing, which is the eligibility criteria. So if you are a graduate or a postgraduate, you are eligible to apply for this role. You need to have good communication skills in English, both verbal and written. You need to have good knowledge of MS Excel. You need to have good problem solving skills, and you can have 0 to 4 years of experience. So you can be a fresher or having up to 4 years experience, then you can apply for this role. Next, we move on to the job description. So I have briefly written about the job description. Here you will have to ensure hassle-free, timely pickup and delivery of freight from vendors to Amazon fulfillment centers and from Amazon fulfillment centers to their carrier hubs. Resolve issues and keep all the stakeholders informed on the proceedings. Network monitoring and significant analysis of network data. Analyze data and notice trends and be able to drive customer experience. So in short, your basic role will be to manage all the logistics of Amazon, right from where its products are stored to its delivery to the end customer. So there will be a lot of stakeholders in between, like there will be sellers of Amazon, there will be transport teams of Amazon. Then you have to manage all of them so that the product reaches the end customer on time and it is stored in the correct place. That is the basic of this role. Now we move on to the interview rounds. So here the round one consists of English grammar and aptitude questions. So I have given the link in the description box for the English grammar test. You can watch that video and then you will understand what kind of questions are asked for this. Then there will be a voice person round. Again, I have already made a video on that. You can watch that. I have given the link in the description. Round 3 will be the HR or the managerial round if you clear round 1 and 2. And in this video, I am going to cover the most common questions that are asked in the HR or the manager interview round for this particular role. Now moving on to the salary part, it is between 2.4 to 4.8. which is a decent enough salary in the range of 20 to 40,000 per month. Location, currently it will be work from home due to the situation. Later you may have to relocate to their Hyderabad office. Now moving on to the interview questions. So first I will cover the questions that are usually asked in the HR round, which are relatively easy as compared to the managerial round. So in the HR round, they can ask you basic questions like walk me through your resume. So you have to then mention your family background. If you have mentioned anything from it in the resume, then the education background, your achievements, the extracurricular activities that you have participated in, and your interest and hobbies. Next, they can ask you why you want this particular job. So here the tip is highlight strengths related to this role and back it up with real life examples. So you can say that you are a good team player, because here you will have to manage a lot of stakeholders and work in teams, so you need to be a good team player. So here you can explain about a team project you worked on in your previous company or in your college. Next, you can say about that you have good critical thinking skills. So critical thinking means analyzing a problem by going into detail and then finding a solution for it. So you can give an example, any example that you have where you demonstrated this skill, like you understood a friend's reason for going into depression and then you helped him out by suggesting him certain ways. You can here highlight you have good communication skills. As an example, you can say that you have participated in debate competitions, etc. Next, they can ask you, are you comfortable working in night shifts or weekends? Because again, here also it is a flexible shift kind of role. So here if you are comfortable, you can frame your answer like that. I do not have any problem working at night and on weekends if it is required by a company. This is because I enjoy doing my work, so nights and weekends don't make a difference to me. Apart from that, I am adaptable to changing environment, so I'll be able to quickly adjust my sleep cycle. So this is the way you can answer this question. Next, moving on to now the managerial round. If you clear the basic questions of HR round, you can move to the managerial round. Here they can ask you some role-based and situation-based question. So this is a role-based question, explains supply chain management. So you should be aware of exactly what supply chain management is, because here, since you will be working as a transportation specialist, you will have to, you know, look at the entire supply chain right from the manufacturing of product to its delivery. So you should be aware of it. So you can say supply chain management is the centralized management of the flow of goods, services, money and information between businesses and location, and includes movement and storage of raw materials, work in process, progress inventory and finished goods, as well as end-to-end order fulfillment from point of origin to point of consumption. By managing the supply chain, companies are able to cut excess costs and deliver products to the consumer faster. So this is the basic purpose of supply chain management, that you should be able to cut excess costs and deliver the products to the consumer as fast as possible. Next, sometimes they can also ask you some aptitude related questions in the interview. So this is a very common question that is asked in Amazon's this particular round. So they can say, how will you measure 4 liters of water when you have 3 liters and 5 liters jars without marking? So here, see, the tip is that you have to look at the end result first. So if you have 3 and 5 liter jars, how you can measure 4 liter water? It is possible only in 5 liter jar that you can measure 4 liter water. And you have to look at how you can get 4 from 5 and 3 liters. So you can get 4 either by adding 1 to 3, so 3 plus 1, or 5 minus 1. So anyways, you need to measure 1 liter water. So how you can measure 1 liter water? You can measure it by this calculation, 3 plus 3 minus 5, so 6 minus 5. That means you have to fill the 3 liter bucket twice. So plus means fill, so and minus means empty, and empty the 5 liter bucket once, then you can measure 1 liter water, and with the 1 liter water you can measure the 4 liters of water. So I'll show you the steps, you will understand. So fill the 3 liter bucket first with the tap, then transfer the 3 liter water to the 5 liter bucket. Now the 5 liter bucket has 3 liter water, then fill in the 3 liter bucket again transfer to 3 liter to 5 liter bucket, but you will be able to transfer only 2 liter because the 5 liter bucket then will fill. Now the 3 liter bucket has 1 liter water. Now what you can do is you can empty the 5 liter bucket and then pour 1 liter from 3 liter bucket to 5 liter bucket. Now the 5 liter bucket has 1 liter water, and then again fill the 3 liter bucket and then pour the 3 liter water into 5 liter bucket. Now the 5 liter has 4 liter water. So now you can measure the 4 liter water. So this is an interview question that can be asked. So next is the situation based question that they can ask you for this role. So a sample question that they ask for this role is, tell me a time when a project didn't go well and what did you do about it? So here, if you are a fresher or an experienced, they can ask you this question. If you are a fresher, you can mention about a college project which didn't go as planned. And if you are working, you can mention about your office project. So here the trick is that you have to measure the star, you have to use the star method to answer this question, which includes the situation, task, actions and result. So start by elaborating the scenario, the situation. Talk about what led to its failure and what, if anything, you could have done differently to prevent it from failing, and discuss the actions you took in relation to the project, and then finally discuss the result of the project and your learnings. So a sample answer could be, you can say, in my previous company, I was assigned a project for an important and high profile client. I was offered the opportunity to add other employees to my team for the job. So this was the situation and the task given to you. Now the action you took, However, I choose to take the majority of the work on by myself, believing mistakenly that if I wanted to do it right, I would have to do it myself. I also wanted to make a good impression on my team lead, so I took the entire work on myself. Then the result, but the workload proved to be too much for me. As a result, the project failed the first time around, I ended up having to hire other team members at the time when I should have already completed the project. And then when you hired the team together, we did end up bringing the project to completion eventually. So now your learnings from that project, I have learned a lot of things. Firstly, teamwork, delegation and working seamlessly with others is sometimes the best and only way to accomplish large tasks such as the one that was assigned to me. Secondly, I realized the fine line between confidence and overconfidence because I felt that by taking the entire responsibility to myself, I became overconfident. Lastly, I also understood that one should have a helpful nature rather than being too selfish. So here you are realizing that since you wanted to make a good impression on the team leader, you were being selfish. That is why the project was delayed. So now you have realized these things and you do not make these mistakes. Next interview question they can ask you is, tell me about a time when you disagreed with your manager. So here I have written a few do's and do nots. So in the do's, you will have to explain the situation again, your point of view, your boss's point of view, which led to the disagreement, and then how you resolve the disagreement. And then do not speak poorly of your boss. Do not try to pretend like you never had a disagreement with a previous boss, or do not get emotional if it is recent. Now you can sample answer for this question. In my previous job, I was assigned to work on a client project on individual basis. After finishing the project, client was quite unhappy with the results. Their CEO directly called my manager and informed him that I have done very poor work and clearly told him that they will not be paying us the pending amount as per contract. So my boss's point of view, after hearing that, my boss called me to his cabin and lashed out at me. As I had also newly joined the company, he had no confidence in me. So he also thought that I have done blunder and perhaps I am incompetitive. So my point of view. But I had confidence in the work I have done. I realized that perhaps the client is playing smart here to avoid making the pending payment after project completion, as mentioned in the contractual terms. And then how I resolved the contract. Therefore, first I tried to calm my boss down, saying that I will immediately rectify my work. Then I asked him whether he has even asked the client as to where I have underperformed. My manager had no answer. Then I suggested him, my manager, that perhaps the client is only doing it to avoid paying us and he should call him now to know where we have underperformed. Then my manager also thought that maybe I am right and hence called the client in front of me to ask about our underperformance. Client unnecessarily pointed out to couple of grammatical errors in report which could easily be rectified. My manager understood client's mischief and reported it to higher management, who eventually took the decision to blacklist this client. So this is how the conflict was resolved, and you were not the guilty party there. Learning, I understood the importance of keeping calm and effective communication to solve any issue. So friends, this was about the interview questions and answers that are asked for this particular position. Now I will quickly show you the link from where you can apply for this role. So I have given this link in the description box. It will redirect you to this page. Here you can also view the job description of this role, the complete job description. And then if you feel you are comfortable for this role, you can fill in these details. How did you find about this job? Your name, email ID, mobile number, all these things, year of passing, all these things, attach your resume and then just submit. And if you get shortlisted for this role, they will call you for further online tests and interview rounds that I've already explained to you. So friends, if this video has been helpful to you in any way, please like this video and subscribe to my channel to get more such videos in future. And I'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.